See, having sex without coming, having sex without releasing, having sex without ejaculating as a woman is, in fact, you're just killing yourself. It's rubbish. In fact, don't even have sex if you know you will not come. If you know this man is not good, don't have sex. And stop faking orgasm. Orgasm is your right as a woman. It's not only the men. Stop. It's not a taboo to tell this man, I want you to make me come. I have never come before. I want to release. Women release. I want to release. I have a lot. I have so many ejaculation built up in me, pent up, that I have not poured out. I want to release. If you're the type that squirts, you tell him, please, I want to squirt. Explore my body. In fact, take it to the all heights. If you don't squirt, you must release. It is your right as a woman. See, having sex without orgasm, without releasing as a woman is like eating white yam without oil, eating white yam without sauce. What are we afraid of? What are we ashamed of? What are we pretending for? Eh? So many of these women, you know how to make yourself come. You know how to make yourself orgasm. Why not teach your men? Why not teach your men how to touch your body? Show him that, please, that when they touch, when they tickle, oh my God, you would come. Instead, you pretend. They will pound you and pound you and pound you aimlessly. So many guys are wacko. So many guys are giving rubbish sex. So many guys are not even meant to have erections. Since when they do? They don't know how to use it. They don't know how to use their finger. They don't know how to use these three fingers, this one, and this one. They don't know how to make good use of them. They don't know how to do anything right when it comes to sex. You think it's only when you put your dick into a woman's pussy, you release some useless sperm, and then it turns into egg. That's when you she's pregnant and turns into a baby making machine. You call yourself a man. No, let me tell you, shame on you. In fact, that kidnapper guy, what's his name, even Evans, is better than you if you're fucking and your woman is not releasing. If you're a very selfish man, if you're the only one releasing, shame on you. If you're the only one, every time you have sex, you ejaculate, you leave that woman wanting, or you put her into the state whereby she starts forming, she starts pretending that she has come. She'll be faking orgasm because she doesn't want to kill your ego. She doesn't want to make you feel bad. Oga, shame on you. You need to step up, man. You need to up your game. This is the 21st century. Women know they lack again. If you think, if so many women will not even send you, when you do first round, they don't even have your time. If you don't know how to do it or more, let them meet another guy that can make it. In fact, worship their body, worship their pussy. Give them that maximum sex, not satisfaction, no, maximum sex satisfaction that they want. Or, girl, madam, they will leave you. They will leave your sorry ass. Do you understand? No matter how, if you are rich, they'll just be there collecting your money. But when it comes to digging it, the sex part, you're nothing, you're zero. Make your woman come. Let her enjoy sex with you. Stop being selfish. So many of you will just tell the woman, open, you enter, and she'll just be there lying like log of wood. You know, because you don't even know how to make her wet. You don't even know places to touch her. You don't even know that there's what we call nipple orgasm. The places, there are ways you have to suck and tickle, touch her nipple. She'll shake with reckless abandon. My dear, make that woman come. It is our right. Do you understand? You're not the only one meant to become. You're not the only one meant to have orgasm. Women, stop faking it. If he's not good, tell him that he is not doing it well. It's not a taboo. The world is revolving. We are changing, we are growing. You get, the way you were last year is not the way you are now. The way you were last month is not the way you are now. This, there's nothing like being ashamed. Men are putting us in this state where we are not meant to voice out our feelings. We are not meant to talk. It is everybody's right to orgasm. He's meant to make you come first before he does. A wicked man will come first before his wife or his girlfriend does. Whatever, whoever it is you're fucking, whoever it is you, make sure you make her come first. Learn to be patient. Oga, there's what we call sperm control. There's what we call body control. There's what we call erection control. Learn how to do all those things. Learn how to knock and pause. You know, when you fuck and fuck and fuck, you pause for a while. When you feel your sperm is about to come out, you pause for a while. You can either pull out your dick, use your mouth, suck her, finger her, locate her G-spot. Do that. Do some of the things, you know, when you're doing, when she's, if she's just enjoying it, you see it in her reaction. And then, women, please stop being log of food. So many of these men say are not wicked. So many of them are willing to learn. So many will be patient, bring out their time, touch you, suck, or you just lie down there like a log of food. You don't make sounds, you don't groan. You know, there are sex sounds, romantic sounds. Like if you're Igbo, you know, If your wife is Igbo, your husband, if you are Igbo people, there are ways you see it. If you are the people that speak Igbo to each other, there are ways you see it. You know, when it's fuck you, you be shouting, Labamo, Lasienike, Lariem, you know, fuck me to pieces, scatter that pussy, he's yours, finish me. You know, you are giving him drive. You are making him, you know, you're making him enjoy and then twist your waist. Don't just lie around there like a log of